run-of-the-mill comedy's honestly possibly the most prominent urban doctrine providing comedians an outlet. Ears to the street aware, we joke heavenly, laughing so hard we grin to preserve energy. Read the articles, bullets and blogs and emails, hit up the MySpace, see us for more. Entertainment digital magazine, distributing the newest and readily available information for you. It's more than a newsletter, now it's a mixtape, auditory visuals for hot live interviews. Drop the each issue, listen to the podcast, log in, hop in the internet, mosh pit.
Frank Holder here for Humor Mill TV, catching up on a lot of comedy news like we normally do. But anyway, this week we've got a comedian known as Speedy, and Speedy does the Foxhole Radio. He's the host. He's been doing that for years. People in LA know all about him. People around the country, they're definitely catching up to find out who this man is. But anyway, this is him, Speedy.
What's up, man?
How you doing, brother?
I'm great.
Thank you for taking out the time. We really appreciate that. Now, first question I got to ask you is, can you explain to the people out there what you do as hosting of the Foxhole?
I have a show on Wednesday called Foxhole Comedy Corner where we just have fun. We take regular serious topics, try to flip them, make them funny, and we do that all day, 7 o'clock on the west, 10 on the east. Friday, we do the Foxhole, which is my man Jamie Foxx is hosting, but I'm one of the characters on the show. It's super funny, man. You got to listen to the show. It's on Sirius 106, XM 149. Every single week, every Friday, 2 o'clock east on the west side. So it's hot.
Well, what made you, as a comic, decide that, you know what, this is something I want to do. Radio's what I want to do. How'd that happen?
Well, when Jamie, once Jamie got the show, got the network, he was like, yo, man, I'm going to put everybody down. And once we got in there, it just became natural for comedians and just in general to get in there. You get on the radio, you start getting the feel of it, and next thing you know, it just grows into this big thing. It happened in 07, here we are in 10. And it's going even stronger now. So it's off the chain. I love doing it, man. I almost love doing it more than stand-ups.
Wow. Would you say that you probably sacrificed a lot of your comedy to do stand-up? I mean, to do the radio portion?
Yes, I did. I would say that, yeah, because I stay home more. More so than I am always trying to look for a road gig and trying to be out on the road. I'll stay home to do radio Wednesday and do radio again that Friday. And then writing the shows and getting the shows together, that takes the whole week to do that. So mainly, unless it's something serious or something really big, then I'll go on the road and do some stuff. But I usually never miss a radio show.
Now, you're doing satellite radio. A lot of people who might not have it, can you explain to them the difference between satellite radio and normal radio is for your show, especially?
I'm going to make it real simple. No commercials. You don't get no commercials. You either get us talking about a subject all for about an hour, hour and a half, or you'll get, we have music on the show. We also have different guests. We have a cooking show on. We have this guy who's, you know, a different lifestyle. He's on Mondays, and he bring it, and he got a fan base. So it's a little bit of everything, but the number one thing is no commercials.
Well, then now, let's fast forward. You have opportunities because you're affiliated with Foxhole. Can you tell us about what's going on in your life now, being that you're affiliated with Foxhole?
Well, the one thing that's definitely going on and I'm just so excited about is Jamie's about to produce a show for me. It's a stand-up comedy show called Stand Up Stand Up. And on this show, we're going to feature three comedians, a new Jack, a middle-of-the-road kind of comic that really hasn't gotten his just, and a comic that's been out there for a minute. And this particular night, we're going to see who gets bragging rights for being the one stand-up comic that can make the audience stand up. And whoever that's going to be, we're going to find out. The comic will get a little bonus money on it on top of it. But the main thing he's going to get is the bragging rights. So we have the new Jacks who feel they haven't gotten their just, or they're funnier than this old guy who keeps getting paid all the time. So this is the one night we're going to find out who's the funniest. What stand-up can make people really stand up from their jokes, from their comedy, from their personality. So we got a new show coming out. It's going to be off the chain. We're going to film it right here in Los Angeles. So we're going to be looking for comedians. If you're a comic out there and you funny, or you think you funny, or you've been in it for a minute and you haven't gotten your just, or you've been doing it for a minute and you want to show these new Jacks that it ain't all easy, that you really got to get in there and have some jokes, you need to get at us. Because this show is going to be hot. It's going to be sketches in between. It's going to be super funny, man. And I'm just happy I'm going to be hosting it. So it's going to be on fire. It's going to really be on fire.
It's interesting, though, that you guys wanted to put something out there now that Fox is doing, the Fox sketch comedy show and things like that. So is there any type of relationship that's going to happen between those two shows? Or is this going to be a complete standalone show?
Completely standalone. Matter of fact, it's under Jamie's new umbrella, his new production company.
Okay.
And so it's totally going to be, you know, we're just going to try to bring the best out of comedians. Most of these comedy shows you see, most comics are going up and winging it. Hey, we're going to see who's going to be funny tonight. But on this show, we're going to find out who gets bragging rights to being the funny comedian that night.
Right.
So that's what shows.
Now, let me ask you this. Why would Jamie even think about doing a different production company? Is it because he wants to help set aside what you're doing?
That's what I'm hoping. Yeah. It's that too, but I think he wants to branch out and do other stuff.
Okay.
And be more or less behind the camera. And I wrote an idea. He liked it. We got a couple other guys in there. My man, Deion Roberts got in on it. So it's a lot of other guys who's coming in to help this thing get off the ground, which I truly appreciate. We're going to be at the Conga Rooms. We're going to be doing it there. And it's going to be off the chain. So I can't wait. So I'm getting in shape.
Let's focus back on you. I mean, we know you write a lot behind the scenes and things like that. I mean, you're always constantly keeping busy, but, you know, a lot of people out there don't know that. What have you written, you know, that's about to bubble that you can talk about besides this comedy show?
Well, I have a movie I wrote called All-Star Weekend. We got that one that we're about to shoot in about another 2 months, I guess it is. Another movie I wrote called Melodies from Heaven. Mm-hmm. And that one's a very, very good movie, family-orientated movie. And got a lot of stuff, man. A lot of stuff in the
way. I see you just tell us a little bit. You don't want to give us too much.
Something.
I know. But I appreciate you taking out the time.
Thank
this
you,
is Speedy Frank Holder here for Humor Mill TV. We're getting ready to knock things out the box real soon.
Yes.
So stay tuned.
Stand up, stand up. Bubble,